Do you know that raising our children with high FQ is arming them with economic self-defense? Ano ba yung economic self-defense? And how do we raise our children to have high FQ? Hi, I'm Rose Press Fausto, FQ Mom. I'm also the president of IFE Management Advisors, Inc. We help individuals and companies have a high FQ. In today's episode of In Life Shiro's FQ video series, we're going to talk about raising our children with high FQ. You know, when we raise our children to have high FQ, we are already arming them with economic self-defense. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Kwentuhan na lang tayo. Di ba kadalasan ng mga magulang nakikialam kung anong gustong course kunin ng anak? Naku anak, huwag ka dyan, walang kita dyan, gutom ang aabutin mo. Bakit ganun? And then the children, on the other hand, they complain, my parents don't understand me, nakikialam sila, they don't want me to be happy. But the reality is, parents are just interfering because they are so uncertain kung gutom nga talaga ang aabutin ng anak nila dyan. But if you are able to raise them to have high FQ, alam mong marunong sila sa pera, you can sit back, relax, and allow them to follow their calling. So how do we teach our children to have high FQ from the very start pa lang? You know, let me share what we did with our children. From the time they were born, we opened their bank accounts already, and that's where we deposited their angpaos and other cash gifts. So by the time they started asking about money, we already had something to show them. You have to teach your children about the difference between needs and wants. Wants can be delayed, but needs have to be satisfied right away. And then the allowance is another important training ground to raise high FQ kids. When we started giving allowance to our children, we gave them on the low side. During that time when their school set a maximum of 100 pesos a day, our allowance to them was 20 pesos a day, but we gave it to them at the start of the week, so that was 100 pesos for 5 days. And we already taught them how to observe the first basic law of money, which is pay yourself first. Pagtanggap nila ng 100 pesos nila, they were already setting aside at least 20% of that amount. 20 pesos nakatabi na para sa savings and investment nila. Here's another tip. During summer, di ba kadalasan ang dami-daming mga summer classes ang naglipa na dyan? So it's another expense for you. Why don't you challenge your children to come up with an earning activity? There was one time when my kids were all into dancing and what they did was that they gathered a dozen of students and taught them how to dance. So they were earning their summer job fee from the dance fees of the children that they were teaching. And then on top of that, they also came up with the recital. Nagbenta rin sila ng parang concert tickets ba? Parang dance concert tickets. So, things like that. Try to discuss with your children, ano bang hilig ng mga anak nyo? Pwede bang pagkakitaan yon? And use the summer in order to exercise their entrepreneurial mindset. Here's one more thing. Why don't you teach your children how to have their own balance sheet? Siguro akala nyo, uy, hirap naman ng balance sheet. Ako nga ayoko nun eh. Baka na trauma kayo sa accounting. Pero yung balance sheet na tinuro namin, mga simple lang. Ang balance sheet lang naman kasi is just a picture of your assets and your liabilities. Para bang selfie ng net asset value mo. So, yung mga anak ko, tinuruan namin isulat kung ano-ano yung mga assets nila. Ito yung mga savings nila nasa banko. Ito yung mga investments nila sa stocks at saka sa fixed income. Tapos, hopefully, wala pa namang mga utang-utang, di ba? So, what did this do to them? They were able to see where their money was going. It was so much easier for them not to buy that latest gizmo, but to just invest it so that their balance sheet total assets keeps on growing. Nakakapogi points kasi pag tumataas yung net asset value mo. To the parents out there, please, I encourage you all to raise your children to have high FQ. Marami pang mga ibang tips, pwede kayong pumunta dito sa mga articles at videos namin sa In Life Shiro's FQ video series. para maibahagi nyo ang pagiging magaling sa pera sa inyong mga anak. Cheers to High FQ! Check out the In Life Sheroes website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about leading a financially empowered life.